next speaker, Nikita, will talk again about some technical issues, I assume. About technical issues. Yeah? Okay, so you have 20 minutes time to get the audience.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nikita Pichugin. I am a student of National Research University of Informational Technologies, Mechanics and Optics, and my topic is the development of the technical indicators ontology. I should begin with explaining what is the technical analysis and what are technical indicators. Technical analysis is the study of market with charts. And the goal of technical analysis is to predict future price shifts. The three principles of technical analysis are first, that the market counts everything. This means that all factors that could affect the price are affecting it. And so all we need to study is the price and its shifts. The second principle is that prices move in trends. There are three trends. It's an uptrend. When price moves up, it's a downtrend. When prices move down, and it's a flat trend. When price don't move. The third principle is that history repeats itself. And we will say many facts about market future if we study market past. And that's why chart analysis is so important in technical analysis. Technical indicators are functions that take price, volume of trades, or something other as parameters. And these functions, these technical indicators, are used to help analyze charts and thus predict market future. And there are many indicators today. Some of them are common and some of them are used in very specific situations. And it is important to know that many indicators have inner connections with each other. For example, to calculate an indicator called MACD, one need to calculate three other indicators called EMA. Let's look closely at MACD example. We have to plot two lines. The first is called MACD line, and calculated as the subtractions and is two EMAs. EMA stands for exponential moving average, and I will talk about moving averages a bit later. And the second line, called MACD signal line, is just another EMA based on the first MACD line. Okay. On the top of the picture, you can see a chart and two EMAs with 26 period and 12 period. They are called slow and fast EMAs. The blue line at the bottom is their subtraction. It's the MACD line, and the red line is a signal line. Analyzing the convergence and divergence of the blue and the red line, we can say when to buy or sell shares, for example. So we have a complex system of indicators that connected in some way. And with an ontology of technical indicators, we can classify indicators, describe their connections, and can describe their structure. The ontology then can be used as a source of information about technical indicators and as a base for future researches in technical analysis. This is the structure of our ontology. Let's look closely at four main bases. The base clade is called thin, and plot class represents functions plots. For example, that blue and red line of MACD. This class is in development stage now. Next class is fundamental. It represents statistically measured market parameters such as price, volume of trends, trades, or and so on. Input class represents parameters that functions take. And tech indicator class represents technical indicators. For example, let's describe the widest used indicator, the simple moving average. It is so flexible indicator that there are even entire books dedicated to this indicator. Generally, SMA is calculated using this formula. Obviously, there are two parameters, N and P. N is an amount of time periods. And P is a function value. In our case, it can be price, for example. And it is important to say that there may be a need to shift the whole plot by some value. So there will be an additional parameter called displace. Let's see where the SMA class should reside. Obviously, it is a subclass of moving average class. And also, SMA is a trend following indicator, so one can study a trend with it. Now we describe the parameters. All parameters have their names or string identifier, as it's called in the ontology, and some value. N parameter will have string identifier length because it is the length of time period, and some integer value. Displace will be described the same way because it is integer 2. But P parameter is slightly different because it's a price. This means that it is a fundamental input and must have an instance of price class as a value. And also we should state explicitly that SMA takes exactly three parameters. And now we can describe specific SMA. In this example, we have my SMA individual, which is instance of simple moving average class, and has three inputs. First is my displace that has zero value, has string identifier displace, and is instance of int input class. My length is an instance of int input 2, has string identifier length, and has value of 9. And the third input is my price, is an instance of fundamental input, has a string identifier price, and has fundamental value close. So it is a close price of the stock. And today there is a method to describe what an indicator is, but not how it is calculated. One of the next steps is to develop the plot class in the ontology, so we can describe how to calculate specific indicator. And the other thing to do is to add more indicators to the ontology, of course. So this ontology would be richer and better. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?
Thank you. So very interesting. For me, this looks like I should invest in this company because then I know to which stock market and which company I should invest. So first question, when you build your ontology, what do you use? Do you use COS, OWL, or anything else?
We are using Web Ontology Language, OWL, version 2, because it is recommended W3C standard, and it is open source standard. So that's the main reason why we choose Web Ontology Language.
Any question from the audience before I ask my next one? No? So, have you done any tests where you can check your quality of your prediction, like precision, recall? Like, did you predict that Facebook will drop down as much as they did?
Unfortunately, we have no informational system or training robot so far that can use this ontology. But in future, of course, we will develop one.
Thank you. Anatole.
I can do it without one.
No, it's good exercise.
One question, is this ontology that you described, is it open? Can it be downloaded by people?
Of course, this is ontology, is licensed under Apache license. It is open source, so you can share it, download it freely, fork it, and even participate in its development and any other thing that you can do with open source information.
Thank you.